Good morning. Is it the morning? It's bright and shiny morning. No, it's gray and perfect day. Silent, silent has descended on earth because we do not know how to be a human being. We do not know how to be a human. We do not know what to do with the human faculties. We do not know how to keep our thought and emotion. We do not know what to do when life is touched by so many different ways. We do not know when the life doesn't happen our way. We do not know how to conduct ourselves when the life is touched by danger, fear, uncertainty. We do not know how to act when life is challenged. We do not know how to become a human when there are changes in our life. We do not know what is appropriate. We do not know how to walk this planet gently when the times are fragile, when the times are uncertain, when the times are extremely and more seriously unknown. Do we know anything at all? Do we know how the nature is going to act? Do we know how our neighbor is going to turn? Do we know how the society is going to behave? Do we know anything at all? The answer to all of this is simply, we do not know. The world can throw it, or the world can throw us anything. What mustn't get thrown around is just you. As a human being, there's two ways one can be, and that is to run our own world in your head with your psychological drama, and run a real world by getting out and living it. The only world that you will ever get to know is the world that is in transaction with you all of the time. The world that you see through a glass screen with sound and light seems to be more of a world to you than the real world that is living, transacting with every living life out there. What is so sad is that we, as human beings, individually run up a psychological world with the eyes closed and with the eyes open, unable to shut and just be. Just being is the most profound way to be as a human being. Just acting in your psychological, nonsensical nonsense is driving so many people off the edge, out, The sane and insane is a fine thin line. No human being is capable of maintaining on one side, and if you did so, that it's not natural. By jumping between the two all of the time, because the world did not happen your way, is causing tremendous hardship, tremendous trouble, tremendous pain and suffering to so many that are close and so many that are far. One must never cross between the line, between the two sides of sane and insane. One must constantly maintain a conscious, awakened state to remain peaceful, remain gentle, and remain alert to the life process you are by doing so. The profoundness, the gentleness, the consciousness will become the center of one's life, and in alignment with the universal, the existence center of life. In doing so, health, well-being, pleasantness, and thought, emotions, and energies may also return to the center of your life. Remain energetic, healthy, and do what is needed, and do what is necessary at all given circumstances in life. Thank you, and may your day become a pleasant and a useful day for you, rising beyond the doorway and exploring life the way it is. What is possible and what's not possible, it's not down to you to determine or to make decisions. It is nature's decision. We are just a speck of the nature's and the creator's and creation. All we can do as an individual is have this immense possibility to experience as an individual, and that is more significant. The individual experience is more fantastic, yet your individuality mustn't rise to the head and topple you and break your legs. Your individual experience must enhance you as a human being to a higher possibility. This is the greatest significance and the greatest choice. Is it the greatest living experience that one can ever able to speak, able to sense, feel, touch, and sense through our perceptions. By being dimensionless, you can take that experience to the beyond. May that become the reality for you and everyone around you.